So I went to the internet and I got this cool little misting nozzle. What I'm gonna do is stuff this guy straight in there and weld the nipple into the hole. And that'll be the water injection.
All right, so what this is a primitive vortex filter. And what it does is, in theory, remove the largest chunks of wood from the stream that's going into the turbo. And if you look at the turbo from the last turbo we blew up, it sure does look like it ate some chunks. So that's what this guy is going to prevent from happening. You may have seen something similar on a bagless vacuum or something in a wood shop called a dust collector. Basically what happens is the particle-laden gases enter tangentially into this chamber and collide with the wall, dragging along it and losing energy and then falling to the bottom, while the gases are still permitted to escape out the top. Ordinarily, these things are engineered based on the flow rates and particle sizes and densities and all sorts of parameters. This, however, is not engineered at all. I just found this propane tank on the side of the road one day and decided it would be pretty good for this purpose. So the next step is to build essentially the up pipe that's going into the turbo. This is just gonna stick in there. I'm gonna cut that to the right length. We don't really know what the right length should be. Again, this is not engineered, but my gut says that the bottom of the pipe should stick down below the bottom of this entry tube, and it shouldn't be too close to the bottom so as to re-entrain the particles that settle down. So probably halfway is about good. I don't know, let's get the turbo out and wave it at the whole thing, see what happens. I think it was over a year ago, I actually just bought two more turbos. Put this one back now. We'll get to it. Yeah.
That's a big boy.
That's a big boy. I think we want the fire to go that way. Plus, I want to be able to ride the turbo furnace in the future, so I'd like the thrust to be directed back.
All right, so what's the next step?
Cut 15 inches off that pipe, and then we're gonna make a flange.
It totally works.
Okay, great. So now we gotta hole saw it.
Oh no.
Your favorite operation. That'll do.
Delightful.
It's a big gap. A few tens of hours of welding practice.
Yeah, I think there's a difference, bud. Yeah, we got the super stinky old arc welder, and there's the TIG, and that's the difference. No, actually, the arc weld one's like not too bad.
It's not bad. I mean,
there are some stinky
porosity.
Do we want to try and grind that surface like just a little bit?
Yes.
All right. And then we'll weld that into the propane tank.
Okay, is there anything stupid? Are we doing anything dumb?
Okay, so the question is, how do we have this completely wrong?
Unless we're radically not thinking about a thing, it's probably fine. Ooh, yeah, oh yeah.
It broke something. The problem here is that we neglected to grind this surface flat before we welded it to the propane tank.
All right.
Good luck.
Good luck.
I didn't like that.
This is bad. Really bad.
It's too heavy and I can't control what I'm doing.
Too hasty with the welder, too hasty with the belt grinder, and too much of a perfectionist. But this will do the trick.
It's kind of coming along, other than the terrible low spots that I made. Now that I switched to the coarse file, in fact, it's going a lot faster.
So before we go Teflon-ing everything together and getting it super tight, we wanted to pull this thing apart and actually gasket these joints So we're making sure we're not losing any hot gases through there. And with all the time I spent filing on this thing, definitely want to make sure we get a good seal on that. It's all magical thinking, boys. It's just hoping in one hand and lighting fires with the other. Remember when we were just doing kettlebell stuff with the turbo and then we killed it? Remains of the turbo from last time.
Yep.
Yuck. This thing will make an appearance in Iron Smelting Quest. Okay, so now that we got those gaskets and everything bolted down on here, we're gonna keep going with Teflon-ing all of these little pipes.
We could ask YouTube, are you supposed to put Teflon on comp fittings?
Yeah, if it's like a flare or a comp, or we don't know what it is, we're putting Teflon on it. It's probably not required. There's two more.
I don't know, we're just too dumb.
I'm here for a job thing. But I love the Turbofurnace project.
Everett just had the idea for the actually making the throttle control for the Turbofurnace like a foot pedal, and I think we're actually gonna do that.
Oh, it's too nice.
I saw that I could definitely wiggle the exhaust gas temperatures around in water.
So, why didn't it start?
Yeah, so it looks like it blew the gasket. And there's a big old hole blown in this boy. It's post-run, we got it back in the shop. See what we caught in the filter. Lots of very fine dust. Look at that, there's no chunk. Not a single chunk.
It's so fine.
It's extremely fine.
Yeah, look at that, whoa.
It's all. Yes. Holy Jesus. This is probably pretty bad stuff to breathe. Since we blew that big hole in there, we're probably gonna take the whole thing apart, and it will be interesting to see what else we find in there.
We need to redo the door, do you agree?
Door needs to be redone. There's confirmed a gigantic hole in it.
And then we need to redo the filter.
Yep. And I think we need to do some math to figure out which direction on the filter needs to be redid. Like, we need to actually engineer it a little bit. I mean, I was watching for sparks and crap flying out of the exhaust, which we have seen previously, but not on this one.
Just smoke.
And we are looking at this guy here, and no cracks, no scratches, no chipping, no problems yet.